And in today's video, I need a little bit more of the motorbike. So here I come around the corner and there's a little root that's going to grab the thing. And that's where it starts. Smile. Right with attitude. Attitude matters. So this is the way back to the ferry after a day of riding with Bret Tkacs here, introducing us to the trail. And there's no audio now, but there will be in a minute. So let's just test the audio quality here a little bit when Bret starts chatting and does the briefing for the day. Here we go. Go, Bret.
The whole idea here today was to try not run a big organized event. You know, so that's why I don't have a waiver or any responsibility.
There are all the bikes out there. So I heard a lot of feedback. This is actually the pedal that I did as well at the end of the day, which was an insane, yeah, I call it a lake, but that's just me from the Netherlands. If we see this, we're gonna get the canoes ready, right, to evacuate. And here it is, 4 or 5 hours of unbelievable trails in the Tehuli region. And just kind of like navigating this stuff. As you can see here, it's mud. I was obviously quite slow and on a heavy bike, but I'm still getting a lot of feedback here. Let me turn that down a little bit so I can actually do some narrating and see if the levels of the audio are correct. So yeah, second gear, maybe third gear. I don't think I really touched that at all during the day, but there's a lot of stuff here. And I actually just wanted to show the fun pieces, the fun parts, because there's so much that is probably not fun and a little boring to watch, but I still like it. As a Dutchie coming from 7 meters underwater and then going to drive these forests that are just endless all around us, it's quite unique. There's a lot of these kind of like, almost like bobsledding corners going on there, and here there's a little ledge off to the right, so you're like, it's quite intimidating when you're on the track, to be honest with you. And so yeah, it was a day of huge challenges for me. I never done this kind of riding before, or there's some challenging pieces in there that Bret laid out for us that day. You can almost feel it, like as you go through the bike, as you go with the bike through the scenes. You'll see later some pieces where we're helping each other out, so there's about 16 people maybe. Just also testing out the new mic here and the new HyperX headset today. It's kind of weird because you have audio feedback going and you can't hear yourself talking, so it's a little bit of a weirdness. Look at the sun through the trees here. Beautiful. Oh, there's Jose on the back. So Jose had street tires and he did okay, but it was just very hard to keep the grip for him, as you see him kind of like navigating the early corners there of the track. He's around the corner. And then we have to help each other up. You can see the tire there is, you cannot see it on the stream because my video's in the middle. It's kind of like a street tire. Next time you get exhausted. So Jose here was really knocked out. It was just, you see the steam coming out of his. He's like a matador next to the bull lying on the ground there, but he he's trying his best. You get just super exhausted. So revving some people on the two strokes over there on the left. Jose driving again ahead, so I teamed up with him in the beginning. And here's a piece we need to go uphill, and actually we met Bret here. This is not that far in, it's only like the first few hundred meters. And he had to stop because there were people up on the road, so we had to actually... There's Bret filming behind with his GoPro. We had to kind of help him down a little to get the momentum going to get up the hill again. There's Eric. So I rode with Eric the whole day. He's the guy with the Araya helmet. This. Bret's kind of giving directions on how to do this. And this is me tackling it in one go. Momentum, momentum, momentum. Decently steep to some roots. I ended up hitting the base of the bike a lot. There's Bret's GS, so he rode the whole day on the GS. Attitude, manners, start of the day.
Down.
Jose talking about we got a man down.
Look at that smiling mug, huh? And then like 4 hours of the most boring footage.
4 hours of the most boring footage ever.
That I have. So it might, you might see me fly by the camera. See, I got the mount for my helmet and I forgot to grab it.
True. I can also put it on the head of clip.
Oh. I don't know if I trust that clip. That clip doesn't look all that strong.
Well, it's pretty decent.
Oh, is it?
Last year I had it on the air. Which,
really?
Because your hand doesn't move that much.
All right. So that's, we're good. Well, go. Ready? Well,
that's Eric, which was great to ride with Eric that day. Smiling mug is what he calls it. Oop, dive for a little branch here. Yeah, this looks pretty fast, but maybe it's not that fast in reality. I don't think I did a lot of second gear on this trip. It's just, like, I always talk continuously through the whole journey as a kind of a means of focus. Yeah, so it was the 100,000 subscribers celebration, right, with Bret. I've watched many, many of his videos, so it was last year, all the riding I did was inspired by his techniques and driving skills. So I come from a background of off-the-roading only in the army, in the big army truck and the fuel truck. So for me, the Himalayan is a way to reconnect with my past when I was 18 years old.
I don't know if anybody would need help coming down that hill.
Yeah, that was a little interesting.
I think that was that hill that he was talking about, Herb. If you get all...
Oh, that was actually the end of the whole day. It's not in sequence. Here goes Eric. Check this out. Look at the back. It's like dancing. These are the cool dark parts.
Well, that was cool.
That was cool. So I did that back in the army in Germany. It's actually interesting that now you have the Ukraine story, but back then it was before the fall of the Berlin Wall. What do you call it? The fall of the US, the Soviet Republic, USSR. And we were staring at the Russians back then. They were amassing there, of course, the USSR. And now you have the Ukraine situation. But that's when I was driving a big truck with fuel. And talking about dropping the bike and falling over, well, I actually dropped the truck, the 4-ton truck, on its side into a ditch. This is beautiful. Look at how beautiful this is. It's this whole area that probably had a forest fire back in the day. And you just get to ride through this. And it's green, lush, growing again. It's quite intense because it's
a little interesting.
I think that was that hill that he was talking about, Herb. If you get all...
Oh wait, I have this double now? That's interesting. I understand why this is in there twice. Screwed up the editing a little bit here. Here we go again with Eric. So yeah, I think the Himalayan brings back the memories of that very bare, very basic, simple, utilitarian machine that you can just maintain, and you can have your simple system of maintenance and cleaning and hygiene and organization that you have in the army. So there's something ingrained in my brain of this driving around on bikes and or off the road at least, that I am reconnecting with, I guess. He's great. He was with us the whole day. His bike occasionally didn't start well, but he was always there trailing and making sure everybody was okay. So it's a great team, great group. This is a cool little corner here with the sun behind it again. Standing up, you see the GPS, the Garmin on the front, so you always can track the trail. You can backtrack where you've been, and if you have no cell reception, you have very good GPS signal, obviously. Issue getting up a hill, I guess.
No.
That's tree. By the looks of it. Is that tree? I think it was tree trying to get up there. Just park the bike and make sure he can get up there. He probably didn't even notice I was back there. checked the tire, it looked a little soft there, a little flat. Just checked it by kicking the tire. Look at the sun. This is January. End of January, right? Great day. Beautiful riding. And I'm still reliving it because it was intense. If you're not used to this, it's pretty cool. Some slippery pieces here. Definitely gotta watch out. Some rocks. Try that. I need some more technique for these corners. Throw the bike around a little bit more. Rock, stone, twitches. What do you call it? Not the twigs. Roots. The roots are very tricky. Here you got gravel in corner. I don't know how to go through there sideways just yet. Tree trunks and roots in corners. Rocks and sand. You constantly have to read your line, and then even with more slippery tires, you can do it. As long as you really balance, there's tree. Make sure you pick your right lines and balance your bike and do it carefully. And I guess we're kind of the same pace. I don't know if we're holding each other up. Some people seem faster, but this is just not much you can do here unless you have an off-the-road cross two-stroke kind of thing. Two-stroke 250 or something, 350. Probably be really fast. You saw those guys there too. We are all the adventure bikers going through here carefully with bikes that you could easily drive back to Seattle with. These are the kind of bikes you can do the whole country with. So that's a tree. Hey, tree. Good riding with you. There we go again. That's somebody complimenting the Himalayan. This was the only Himalayan on there that day. I know some people really liked it. I know Bret rode it in over in Nepal with all those broken pieces that they had. The really badly maintained bikes, so they were not. Although I think Bret's wife was quite keen on Himalayas, despite what they experienced over there. Here, big route. They were just badly maintained bikes, but there's this trust thing, right? If you see major welds disintegrating, then you gotta worry a little bit. So I'm definitely, although I had an amazing day, nothing wrong with the bike at all. And I rode back through here, to the evening, through the I-5 all the way back to Kirkland. So look at this. Amazing scenery. And the thing with the Pacific Northwest is that it's just endless. You're surrounded by, like, say, a planet of green here is what it appears, what it feels like. So even though there are pieces that are burned 10 years ago, they grow up again. There's harvesting of trees going on, but it's endless here. The amount of trees, the Olympic National Park is the size of, I don't know, a quarter of the Netherlands or something like that. Maybe even half. It's so incredibly large. It's just wilderness and jungle here. So in that sense, doing this here feels less damaging, although you could easily do it on an electric bike, right? Lots of torque. I'm talking here, but I don't think you can hear it anyway. So in that sense, it doesn't feel like your impact is bad, even though, yeah, you could say an EV would be better now. Electric motorbike. Here, those roots are at an angle, right? So you see, it's just an endless. I think I'm just going to do the whole video and then put it out. I didn't really know how to edit it. There's so much. So for people who really enjoy the track, just have me with a cup of tea talking through it. I didn't put my cap on. My trucker's hat. Now I got my trucker's hat on. Obviously it's a lot better, and then we can do some. What's going on here? Again, double footage. That's Jose. Okay, let's do a little bit of Jose here. I think this is earlier in the video, so, and roll with Jose. Also the Ducati here, so that we can do some bike traction theory later. Leave that up to me. Jose was putting his foot down a lot, which I think is a little risky if you hit a rock or something like that. And if you walk through these corners. Hey, there's Eric.
What's up, Eric?
What's up, Eric? There's Jose to the corner. A lot of rocks. Kneels down next to the stricken bull.
I got a cramp in my back.
Oh.
Cramp. So it's exhausting.
Is it falling
on your back? No, I'm fine.
Okay. Just cramp?
Just a cramp.
Okay. I'll stop filming.
There's Eric.
I see you.
And Jose. So here we see Jose taking off. I think he still did a nice bit of piece of track. He just had a few moments when it was. The bike is, I'm not sure what bike it was again. Triple. You see these roots at an angle? Cutting up the hill here. Trying to get grip was hard on this bike. There we go. Up the hill. Now from a standstill, getting up this steep little thing is fun. I mean, you hear that sewing machine purring, it's a tractor. You see all those roots? I mean, I'm definitely kind of an amateur at this too. It says first year. Is Eric?
It's hard work.
We're actually going to make it through this video of 29 minutes. Oh, there we go. You've seen this before too. What? And then we'll call it a day. So yeah, it's not an edited movie. It's just everything together and then me talking over it. So yeah, from an army truck driver to a Himalayan rider looking for more exploration in the Pacific Northwest. We've done this already. There's doubles in here for sure.
Yo, what's up, doubles. Eric?
Hey. Eric and I took the ferry back in the evening. It was awesome, yeah. It was a great sport to drive with. And very, very able throwing his bike around, by the way.